Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Bhavna Joshi and I will be taking the subject Childhood and Growing Up. So in this subject today we will be studying about the gross and fine motor development. As we have already studied about the definition of gross motor skills and the fine motor skills, today we will be studying the developmental chart starting from the birth till the age of 8-9 years. What are the developmental milestones with respect to gross motor skills and the fine motor skills? So, as you can see on the screen, when the child is of the age from birth till 6 months, the developmental milestone with respect to gross motor skill will be that he will be able to roll back, he will be able to sit with support. And by independently also. And if this milestone is not achieved, then what are the possible implications? As you can see on the chart, 6 months maybe there will be poor muscle development for locomotion and there will be delayed ability to play independently. So when the child grows up to the age of 12 months, 6 to 12 months, the developmental milestone here is the child starts to crawl at this point of time. He can sit on his own without any support. He can, creep on his hands and knees. He can walk holding the furniture. And he can take 2-3 steps. It could be that by the age of 12 months the child can walk easily. But in some cases. But the normal phenomena says that the developmental milestone will be for the 12 months will be that the child will be able to walk holding furniture. And can take 2-3 steps, roll a ball to an adult. So this is the gross motor development milestone. And if it is not achieved, then what? Then there is delayed sensory development due to decreased ability to explore the environment around. There is poor muscle development and delayed play skills also. Now, when the child grows up to the 18 months of age, that is approximately in 1.5 years. So, when the child is of 1.5 year, he will be able to sit, he will be able to crawl, he will be able to walk, he will be able to, push against a ball, not exactly kick, but he can push against a ball. And if it is not achieved these developmental milestones, then automatically there is delayed play skill. There is difficulty in interacting with the environment due to ability to mobilize efficiently. And there is poor muscle development. So let's go to the 2 years of age. When the child reaches to 2 years of age, the developmental milestone will be he can walk smoothly, he can turn corners. He begins running at this age. He can carry his toy on his own with his hands and can walk easily. He can walk up and down in the stairs also. He can pick up toys from the floor without falling down. The balance of the body is made by this age. And if it is these developmental milestones are not achieved, then the possible implication will be that there will be decreased ability to interact socially because the child is not able to do all these things. There will be poor muscle development. There will be delayed ability to play independently and interact with the environment. Now, next is the age of 3 years. Now, with the age of 3 years, the developmental milestone will be, imitate standing on one foot. He will be able to stand on one foot. He can imitate simple bilateral movements of limbs like arms up and down together. Then pedal the tricycle. Then walk up and down the stairs easily, then able to walk on tiptoes and catches the ball using his body and hands. Now, if this milestone is not achieved, the possible implication can be that there is decreased opportunities for social interaction, as we discussed earlier also, because the child is not able to move freely. There is poor development of body awareness. Difficulty is there using the playground equipments. Then there is difficulty and lack of confidence also, because the child at this age, 3 years of age, he goes to the park and interact with the child, with the children around. He started going to the play school also. So lack of confidence is there, because the other childs are able to, you know, walk, run, catch the ball, ride a tricycle, but the child is not able to do so. So there will be lack of confidence also. Now, the next is 4 years of age. So developmental milestone at this stage will be stands on 1 foot for up to 5 seconds. He can easily stand up, then kick a ball forward. He can throw a ball with his, you know, swinging his arms and overarms. He can easily throw the ball like a bowler. True baller. Then he can run around obstacles. He is able to walk in a line. He can hop with 1 foot and jump over objects and land with both feet together. Now, if this milestone is not developed, there will be lack of confidence. There will be difficulty in using playground equipments. So with the 5 years of age, the developmental milestone are like he's able to walk upstairs without holding, while holding an object, you know, a toy is in his or her hand and he's able to walk up the stairs. And then he can walk backward, toe and heel. He can jump forward without falling. He can jump 10 times, 20 times also without falling. Then he can step forward with leg. He can catch a small ball using his hands only. So now he's a grown up boy or a girl. Then possible implication which is that if the child is not able to achieve these developmental milestones, then there will be the poor self-esteem will be poor, because he constantly will be comparing himself with the peer group. There will be lack of confidence in movement of based activities. He will find it very difficult to participate in sporting activities, and difficulty while playing with moving toys such as, you know, riding a scooter or a bicycle. It will be difficult for him. Now, when the child reaches 6 years of age, the developmental milestone here will be that he runs lightly on toes. He will be able to walk on a balance beam. With making a balance, he can walk in that. He is able to skip using a skipping rope and can cover 2 meters of hopping easily. He demonstrate, you know, mature pattern of throwing and catching. Neatness is there in when he throws and catches a ball. And the jumping is more mature when he or she reaches the 6 years of age. Now, the possible implications, if these milestones are not achieved, then again there is difficulty in participating. There is, it can result in poor self-esteem also. That why a child may have the feeling that why I am not able to do so, and why others are so easily can do this activity. There is lack of confidence also in the child at this age. So these were the gross motor developmental chart. Now comes the fine motor developmental chart. Now, with respect to fine motor development, as I told you that fine motor development is when the child is able to use his fingers, his thumb and a finger to hold something, to pick up something. So that is fine motor development. So when the child is from 6 months of age, that is birth till 6 months, the developmental milestone will be reflexive grip, voluntary grip, by three months of age. Then he will be able to two-handed palmer's grip, then one-handed palmer's grip, and then there is a very controlled rich grip by the age of 6 months. And if this milestone is not achieved, there is poor muscle development, there is delayed ability to play independently, he will not be able to play independently, he needs some support. Then delayed sensory development also, because he is not able to interact with his toys and sensory objects. Then by the age of 12 months, that is the age group of 6 to 12 months, the developmental milestone here is he or she reaches grasp and put object in mouth. You know, he is able to pick a ball in his or her hand. Then he or she can put that object in the mouth also. So the whole process involves the use of fingers and hands. So controlled release of object, pincer grip, and then transfer object from one hand to another. He is able to transfer it. Then the possible implication, if this milestone is not achieved, then it is poor development of hand and finger strength is there. That means hand and finger is not developed fully. There is manipulation of objects, that means resulting in delayed play skill. He's not able to play with the toy. So obviously there is delay in it. Then delay sensory development, again, because he's not having that sensory experience, play experience. Then when the child reaches 1 to 2 years of age, he or she is able to build towers using, you know, blocks, the big blocks. He or she is able to make tower. Then turn the pages 2-3 times. He is able to knob. He is able to self feed with minimal assistant. He is able to, you know, tear a chapati and put it in his or her mouth without any assistant. Then able to use signing or to communicate. He's able to use signs like, you know, using his finger to tell something. Then hold and drinks from the cup independently. Now by the age of 1-2 years, he can hold the glass or a cup and he can drink water and milk on his own. Then if this milestone is not achieved, that means possible implication can be that poor development of hand and finger strength is there, delayed independent play skill is there, then delayed development of self-care is there, and manipulation skills is also delayed. Next comes the age group of 2 to 3 years. Now, milestone here is he is able to turn single pages easily. When you give him or her book, he is able to turn single pages, snips with scissor. He is able to work with scissor, and then uses one hand constantly in most activities. He is able to paint with some wrist actions. He can able to, you know, make dots, lines. He is able to eat without any assistant. He is able to hold the spoon on his own and can eat easily. Then the delay, possible implications if this milestone is delayed, then it is that delayed self-care, which means because he or she is not able to eat on his own. Then delayed pre-writing skill development when the child holds the pencil. This is the age when the child first holds the pencil, making a line, straight line or slanting line or a sleeping line. So there is delayed manipulation of small objects such as, you know, toys, pencils, scissors. Then frustration when manipulating small toys and objects because he or she is not able to do it. Now the next is the age of 3 to 4 years. At this age, the child is able to build the blocks, small blocks. He or she is able to build a tower of 9 or 10 small blocks easily. He or she is able to manipulate the blocks and make different things out of it. Then manipulate clay also. He's able to make ball. He's able to make different objects like snakes or cookies or something like this. Then he or she uses non-dominant hand to assist and stabilizes the use of object. The child can easily pick up a thing and use it on his own as per his or her convenience. Then if these developmental milestones are not achieved, then obviously it means that there will be delayed pre-writing skills development at this age, because the child is not able to hold the pencil. Then their frustration is their avoidance of pencil-based tasks. He feels frustrated because he or she is not able to hold the pencil rightly. Then poor pencil grasp and pencil control, poor self-care skills like eating on his or her own, delayed drawing skills. Now the next is the age group of 4 to 5 years. Developmental milestone at this age will be cuts on line continuously. He or she is able to write his or her name, writing numbers. This is the age when the child goes to preschool, nursery. So he or she is able to write the alphabets, the numbers, and dresses and undresses himself or herself independently. Now, a possible implication if the milestone is not achieved, then it is like difficulties holding and manipulating a pencil. Then there will be difficulty in learning to write all the alphabets and numbers and doing, you know, day-to-day activities like dressing, eating. It will be difficult for the child. Then again, there will be, you know, frustration, a lot of frustration, and the child will avoid using, you know, having those things which involve the use of fine motor skills like writing tasks. So he or she will avoid the use of pencil and writing tasks because the developmental milestones are not achieved yet. Next comes the age of 5 to 6 years. So at this stage, usually the child is able to cut simple shapes like a triangle, circle, a rectangle. He or she can copy a triangle. The child can color within lines. The color will not go out of the drawing object. Then using a three-fingered grasp of pencils and using fingers to generate movement also. Now the child is able to paste and use the glue if appropriately. Now the possible implication of not achieving the developmental milestone could be that there is difficulty in learning to form the letters correctly. Handwriting will be poor. Academic ability on paper demonstrating it will not be good. And fatigue during pencil-based task, then again there will be frustration and avoidance of these tasks. Now next comes the age group of 6 to 7 years. So at this age, the developmental milestone is forming most letters and numbers correctly. Now the child is able to write constantly on the lines. The writing, there is good adherence for writing, and he or she is able to build echoes also, you know, minute blocks, and the child is able to make different things of his imagination, like a house, like a helicopter. It could be anything. So he or she can use Legos. Then tie shoelaces also. The child is able to tie the shoelaces by the age of 6 to 7 years. Then a possible implication could be difficulty getting idea down on paper. Then he or she expresses fatigue during handwriting task, very lethargic, or saying that I cannot do it, my hand is paining, my fingers are paining so much. So difficulty in keeping up with class, slow handwriting, those who write slowly, the speed is slow. It could be that the developmental milestone is not achieved yet. Then poor legibility of handwriting is there, may impact on the self-esteem when comparing work with the peer. So automatically it will affect the self-esteem of the child. Then possible frustration could be there, and behavior difficulties could be there. Then comes the age of 7 to 8 years. Here developmental milestone could be maintain legibility of handwriting for entirety of a story. That means the child is able to write the whole story, telling the whole story and writing on his own. Then difficulty, the implication could be that difficulty completing handwriting task in a timely manner. That means the speed of writing is very slow. Experiencing fatigue, then poor academic achievement is there, and difficulty during there will be avoidance of pencil based tasks by the student. So I hope you all understood the motor development chart and the fine motor development chart, starting from the birth till the age of 7-8 years. Thank you very much.